In the second and final module of the orientation lecture for our class, I'm going to discuss the reading materials for the course, the assessment plan for the course. I'll go over the homework assignment that we'll be doing for this weekend. I'll discuss the instructional mode that I've adopted for the course, and I'll give you some general advice or strategies that I've seen be successful for students in doing an online-only critical thinking course over the last couple of terms. Starting with this reading material for the course. I've been teaching critical thinking for almost my entire philosophical career, and I slowly but surely came to realize that critical thinking texts were largely out of step with the needs of students in contemporary society. I began to write individual chapters to address those deficits in the standard critical thinking curriculum. I've gotten about halfway through a total critical thinking textbook, and that will cover about half the material that we look at in this course. For instance, the first 4 weeks, I believe, will be covered entirely by chapters that I've written. All the chapters that I've written are available to you for free. You can download them as electronic PDFs and utilize them for the course without any charge. For the rest of the course, however, I still have to rely on standard critical thinking texts. And the critical thinking text that I use is Patrick Hurley's A Concise Introduction to Logic. Now, most of these critical thinking texts are relatively expensive if they're thorough and complete. And as a result, I encourage students to look for used versions of the text or renting electronic versions of the text from the publisher in order to minimize the cost of that text. All you have to do is make sure that every section in the syllabus that doesn't have a link to one of my written chapters has a corresponding section in the Hurley textbook that you purchase. For those sections of the course like Module 3 here, where I've written a chapter, all you have to do to access that chapter is to click on it and load it into your browser. However, what I've found is that the animations in the movies oftentimes won't play inside the browser. And so what I encourage you to do actually is to left-click on your mouse, click the Save Link As, and save the chapter as a PDF file on your computer. You'll pull up a chapter like this. Yes, I know I've got an obsessive-compulsive labeling and numbering disorder. But the chapters are broken down into sections. They're multimedia. They contain links to places on the web. They contain pictures. They contain videos. And as I say, you're free to use them without any cost or obligation on your part. What about assessment? Well, I'm going to base course grades exclusively upon 7 tests, which will comprise 70% of your overall course grade. Each test will be worth 10% of your overall course grade. There'll be 15 homework assignments, one homework assignment per week, and they'll be worth 25% of your total course grade. The remaining 5% comes in the form of class participation. To earn those 5 class participation points, you have to attend at least 5 of the 7 Zoom review sessions prior to the test, or attend an equivalent period in the office hours where we're studying for one of the upcoming tests. As I mentioned in the previous module, I have a great deal of extra credit available to students. There are 2 extra credit practice tests for every test, for a total of 14 possible extra credit opportunities during the course of the term. For that reason, I assign grades without curving them. A will be 100 to 90%, B 89 to 80%, C 79 to 70%, D 69 to 60%, and anything below 60% will be an F. Since I'm discussing how to assign grades in the course, it seems like a good time to discuss our first homework assignment. This homework assignment, as well as the homework assignment for next week, are slightly different than the rest of the quizzes that I give you on a weekly basis. Those quizzes are beach board quizzes that focus on the material in the lecture and the readings. These first 2 quizzes, however, are what you might call enrichment activities. They don't merely quiz you on the content of the lectures and the readings. Instead, they take the material from the lecture and readings, and through an activity, build upon your understanding of that material. The first exercise is the study habits inventory. Each of these homework assignments has 2 components to it. You start by going to the inventory exercise, clicking on this link, opening up the study habits inventory page. You follow the directions here. You start off by trying to estimate what you think your score will be on a quiz discussing your study habits, what you think your score will be on a quiz discussing your reading habits, and what you think your score will be on a quiz discussing your writing writing habits. Then you print out the questionnaire or answer it online, answering as honestly as possible. You don't have to turn in this questionnaire and you don't have to report your numeric score. What I want you to do is answer as honestly as you can the questions that are asked. Once you answer the questions, like I study course material A several times a week, even if for short periods, B once a week, C only before the test, then you go to the end of the study habits inventory and click on the key. The key will assign points to your answers, allowing you to determine what score you received based on my evaluation. Importantly, at the end of each section, for instance, the section on study habits, there'll be an explanation. This explanation provides you with information about why it is that I assigned the points in the way that I did to the answers. This particular case, in the study habits section of the quiz, I make an important distinction between two different kinds of memory systems. On the one hand, there's procedural memory, and on the other hand, there's declarative memory. These two memory systems are anatomically different systems that operate in different ways. Procedural memory system is the memory system that you use to learn processes, methods, techniques, and skills. The declarative memory system is the memory system that you use to learn facts, ideas, and concepts. And so by understanding how each of these memory systems work, you can better understand how to learn each of these two kinds of course materials, the facts on one hand and the techniques on the other. So study these explanations carefully, and when you're done, go back to the Beach Board page and click on the Study Habits quiz and take the quiz. Now the quiz will test you on the information that is presented to you in the explanations for the Study Habits inventory. So make sure that you understand the explanations as you're reading through them so that you can do well on the quiz. Next week's homework assignment, the information awareness assignment, is another enrichment activity that involves clicking on a link, going, doing an activity, then clicking on a quiz and answering questions related to that activity. I'll end this orientation video by giving you some unsolicited advice. Students generally find online courses more difficult than in-person courses. This is particularly compounded by the fact that we're now dealing with a pandemic, an economic upheaval, and a political upheaval. So there are a lot of challenges to succeeding in this class. My advice to you is to impose a structure, create a schedule, and stick to that schedule. That structure will help you keep focused and engaged in the course. Actively seek feedback. Come to those review sessions. Stop by office hours. If you have questions or you're confused about something, contact myself or Tom through email or come visit us in our office hours. We are here to help you and we want to help you. Finally, make an effort to remain engaged in the course. Try to complete every assignment, even if you don't feel like you did it as good as you'd like to have done it. By engaging with the course on a regular basis, by coming to the class, by creating a structure, you'll help to create a situation that facilitates your successful completion of the course with the sort of outcome that you'd like. I hope you found this orientation video useful, and I hope that you'll find the class interesting and rewarding. I hope to work with you during the course of the term to ensure that you complete the class with the kind of outcome that you'd like, that you feel like you've got some benefit from studying critical thinking under my tutelage. Until then, have a great day and a great weekend.